Hello, Rick Comerick, Certified Financial Planner, bringing you this month's blog post titled A Bounce in Economic Activity and COVID-19 Cases. Last month, I entitled June's post, The Approaching Light Before the Dawn. Much of the economic data at that time was extremely negative, with record declines in employment and consumer spending. The speed of decline has no modern precedent. With the government-imposed lockdowns and business closures, companies furloughed employees at a furious and painful pace. It is difficult to express in words, but it has been disheartening to see friends and family members sidelined from the workforce. We are now in a recession, according to the National Bureau of Economic Research. The NBER is the official arbiter of recessions and expansions. The prior expansion, which began in 2009, officially peaked in February, having lasted a record 128 months. In making its determination, the NBER concluded the unprecedented magnitude of the decline in employment and production warrants the designation of this episode as a recession, even if it turns out to be briefer than earlier contractions. The shortest recession on record lasted just 6 months and occurred in 1980. Second place, a seven-month recession in 1918 to 1919, which was tied to the Spanish flu pandemic. There are five recessions that lasted 8 months, including the 57 to 58 recession that coincided with the Asian flu pandemic. While the economy is much different today, the recovery from the short but steep 57 to 58 recession was robust. That brings us back to last month's title, The Approaching Light Before the Dawn. Given surprisingly strong data in May, April may mark the bottom of the economic cycle. If so, it will be the shortest recession on record. Let's also acknowledge that the speed and depth of the decline had no modern parallels. The U.S. gained 4.8 million jobs in June, which was better than expected. Meanwhile, the unemployment rate headed lower to 11.1% from 13.3% in the prior month. Consumer spending, which fell a record of 6.6% in March and a record 12.6% ouch in April, rebounded by a record 8.2% in May. Pent-up demand, stimulus checks, generous unemployment benefits, and a rise in employment and reopened businesses supported the sales. Consumer confidence is also improving per the Confidence Born Consumer Confidence Index. It remains well below pre-coronavirus levels, but rising confidence and reopenings are supportive of economic activity. Still, not all is rosy, and a strong recovery is not assured as visibility remains incredibly limited. Layoffs as measured by first-time jobless claims are slowing, but remain at unusually high levels. The weekly layoff numbers have been more than double what we saw at the peak of the 2007-09 recession. Forecasting in today's environment. In his testimony before House Committee on June 30th, Fed Chief Powell said, "Many businesses are opening their doors, hiring is picking up, and spending is increasing. Employment moved higher and consumer spending rebounded strongly in May. We have entered an important new phase and have done so sooner than expected." But he also recognized the need to keep the virus in check. The path forward for the economy is extraordinarily uncertain and will depend in large part on our success in containing the virus. A full recovery is unlikely until people are confident that it is safe to re-engage in a broad range of activities, Powell added. We are seeing a spike in COVID-19 cases in many states, which is creating a new round of uncertainty. It has fueled choppier day-to-day activity in the market, yet at least so far, the bull market seems to be coexisting with the rise in cases. Despite higher infection rates, deaths continue to trend lower. This reduces fear somewhat and in turn reduces odds of new lockdowns. U.S. Treasury Secretary Steven Mnuchin took a more optimistic tone in his testimony with Powell. "The Blue Chip Report is forecasting that our GDP will grow by 17% annualized in the third quarter and by 9% in the fourth quarter, which follows what is expected to be a record contraction in Q2. Mnuchin also expects significant progress in the employment front. B-U-L or W-shaped recovery. Economists give recoveries what might be called a letter grade when discussing possible paths. It's not the traditional A through F scale. Instead, the letter intuitively describes the shape of the recovery. A V-shaped recovery would be ideal as it would represent a robust bounce. Might we get a V? Data in May was unexpectedly strong and cautiously encouraging. However, even during what we might consider more normal times, forecasting is difficult. Today, there's no playbook, no framework to model outcomes. I could give you several reasons to see a strong rebound unfolding. I could also give you several reasons why a sluggish recovery might take place. The strong rebounds in stocks since the late March low is astounding, especially given the economic damage. It suggests the collective wisdom of investors is more optimistic. Fed support, rock bottom interest rates, the reopening trade, and stronger economic data have helped. I also believe investors are looking past this year's hit to corporate profits and are expecting an upturn in 2021. The jump in daily cases has created some renewed volatility and it bears watching, but it has not yet knocked the bulls off course. Ultimately, the path of the virus will play the biggest role in how the economic outlook unfolds. Some folks are itching to get back to normal while others remain on guard against the disease and taking a more cautious approach. It may take time for some businesses to get to full recovery and some never will. Last month, I said, don't expect a return to pre-COVID jobless rate anytime soon, but investors are betting that an economic bottom is in sight. Try to look past continued volatility. However, based on recent economic reports, I think we might have hit that bottom in April. As always, I'm honored and humbled that you've given me the opportunity to serve as your trusted financial advisor.